Hey, it's 4 a.m. now, and I just arrived at Seoul from Tokyo for a 16-hour layover. Oh, if you haven't watched the previous episode of my Japan vlog, please click the link here.
No.
You will be arriving at Tosu.
Not Tosu.
While seeing me exploring Incheon Airport, I'd like to share my schedule today. My flight is 7 p.m. and I will have two interviews today. One is at 7 a.m. and the other one at 4 p.m. I thought I would be super bored between my interviews, so I also booked a transit tour here. I will join Peaceful Korea Tour and I will leave the link in the info box. So before I share the story about these two interviews, let me give you some context first in case you are new here. I'm a Taiwanese who used to work in Singapore as an LS developer. I was laid off last September, lost my work visa, and being unemployed till now.
Good morning, it's just another day of me, still having no job, still worrying about being sent back to Taiwan. I had a really, really bad day yesterday, and my eyes are swollen like shit now.
For your information, I studied computer science in university and recently graduated from grad school. I was trying to look for jobs during my grace period, but turns out the job market in Singapore is really bad. Or maybe I'm just not good enough. I didn't pass many resume screenings because as long as they saw I'm not senior enough.
No one is hiring junior developers anymore, neither startups nor large companies.
Or knowing that I need a work visa. Then you know, rejection letter. I did get to interview with some companies, and two actually got me offers, one into the final round, but two companies eventually withdrew the offers due to visa issue. And one after the final round just suddenly said,
hey, we can't hire you anymore, we're looking for senior people now.
Finding a job, especially as a developer in Singapore, is really challenging now. So I thought of expanding my tech stack, because I can also do other things. But Swift is my favorite language and I don't want to give up. Anyway, the other day I saw another JD from a company that someone highly recommended to me before. The tech stack is different from what I'm doing now, but I thought I can write them an email and maybe they will have any iOS roles. Because I heard that this company is really good. Then luckily, the HR contacted me, we had a call, and they decided to proceed my application as a full-stack software engineer. I received the interview invitation when I was in Japan. And that's why I was studying React and React Native and even some backend whenever I was on Shinkansen or any flights. By the way, the interviews I will take today are software engineer fundamentals and system design.
Alright, let's continue.
Oh, that's so long.
I feel like it's gonna be spicy. I can't read anything.
Hair sparkling water?
It's not water.
Let's go. Bye bye. I feel like we should go to airport laundry first. Sorry, I just want to sleep.
I didn't manage to go to the airport lounge because I don't have quota anymore.
Only this big because I have 4 in total.
I also tried this ice cream, and after I finished it, I had my first interview.
I'm going to the tour, and later we'll go walk around. My tour starts for 9. I guess I have a lot of time.
I'm being late. And lots of them.
I'm Brian. Okay, get to the Ulsan and Imjinga and bring you back safely T1 and T2. When you get there, you know, you feel peaceful. You should give a tour to the French tourist. So it came out. But he only worry about, he cannot see every tourist going on trip or not. So he asked us, get a group photo. So there is no free lunch. No exception. There was a battle, the North Korea and South Korea.
Here's the comparison between North and South Korea. Let's go up to the observation deck. By the way, I can only use 3G at this place.
Is that a car? People moving together? Yeah. Car cannot go in there.
I tried to film the scene through telescope, but it didn't go well. So please enjoy the scene of North Korea through my camera zoom in. Can you guys actually see anything there? After we kind of stopped on North Korea for a while, we moved to the next destination.
The end of the cable car, the end there, is Camp Grievous, which is end of the Korean War. Korean government allowed the U.S. troops stay there. The first U.S. camp. 33 leaders, Korean leaders, get together. Like declare we are like an independent country.
Ooh.
And also the 41, the Revolutionary War, Canada, Quebec, number 38. Gulf War, I was there as a U.S. Army. It was on the train. It's like a naturally grow the train. So when the Korean government tried to move this train to here, they moved that tree from there to replant there. The statue is like a statue of a lady. Memorize the girls during the Pacific War. Japanese collected all the young Korean women, Philippine girls, all the girls, send it to the sex slave for the Japanese soldiers. Man and woman grab hands together and you listen to this music and you know where you are. Can you cry? Calling my mother. Oh, mother, father.
Just like a tiny little bit hot dog at the end. And I'm not sure what it means, but I received this warning when I was there. Then I went back to the airport and had another ice cream. Took the shuttle train and had my second interview at the gate. So while I'm on another flight, I thought I would share what I did for the previous two interviews. And yes, I passed two of them and received the third round behavioral interview as well. So the first round is software engineering fundamentals. Here's the prep documentation they sent to me. In this session, I was interviewed by the head of engineering to do live coding. I was asked to implement some backend server APIs and create functions for frontend. And as the interviewer adding more requirements, I have to adjust my solution as well. It was easy as long as you can explain why you make certain decisions, how efficient, effective this decision is, and how it will affect the code base. So I think a good way to prepare for this interview is just using side projects to get familiar with different tools, principles, and write good code. The second interview is a standard system design. Here's a doc they sent to me. I was interviewed by the head of engineering again and another two backend engineers. Yeah, backend engineers. I thought it's a mismatch because I already said that I'm more iOS and frontend developer, but they say that's why they want to know more about my backend knowledge. The question is very practical and they focus more on the server and database side. I was extremely insecure about my answer because I never done the backend system design before. But surprisingly, I passed the interview. I don't think my advice is useful for backend system design. But rule of thumb is still design patterns and architectures and be aware of different tool choices such as persistence, database, server. Choose the right one for the particular situation for mobile and front-end part, which they actually didn't ask. I would suggest checking this GitHub repo and again learning from building different projects. And don't always say MVVN, it's just for the sake of MVVN. Yeah, that was me when I first started iOS development. Arrived at London. Have I told you guys that I was born in UK? Anyway, it's not important. So after I arrived at London, the first thing I did was to enjoy my breakfast with some Vietnamese music in the background. while attending two meetings with Asha. Actually, one of the meetings was with a person who saw my YouTube video and he's kind of interested in Asha. So you guys feel free to check out Asha's website if you'd like to volunteer as well. Then I moved to the hotel and prepared for my third interview, the behavior interview. Move him to TV so he looks better. Then I watch more videos 30 minutes before my interview while having my breakfast.
Hello. So I just finished my interview. I don't know if it goes well, but we shall see. My lips are so dry.
Then for the interview result, the story of the conference I attended and all the UK stuff, please subscribe to this channel and you will see more in the next video or future videos. Alright, see you in the next video.